Hi everybody, I am a chemistry student at Turkey. Today I am going to make some basic experiments.
Today's topic, precipitation of copper carbonate by mixing copper sulfate and sodium carbonate salt. First, I am adding 128 gram copper sulfate.
Also, copper sulfate salts are used in agriculture.
Now I'm adding 350 milliliter water to solve copper sulfate salt. Now I see that 350 milliliter water is not enough to solve copper sulfate salt. So I am adding a little more water. After stirring and heating solution, I see that almost all salt dissolved. Now I'm gonna prepare second solution, sodium carbonate salt. For that solution, I need the 48 gram sodium carbonate salt. Also, sodium carbonate are used in house cleaning. For this experiment, you just need the sodium carbonate and copper sulfate salt. You can get them legally in your local hardware store, and you can make this experiment in your home. I think it's a good way to learn and like chemistry at your own. Actually, in this part, you must wait until you get a clear sodium carbonate solution. You can see my clear sodium carbonate solution while I am mixing copper sulfate solution and sodium carbonate solution. Now, we came most beautiful part of the experiment. I add copper sulfate solution and sodium carbonate solution. Now you can see precipitation of copper carbonate. This is the reaction that takes place. You can see the carbon dioxide and copper carbonate products.
A few moments later.
Now we can see copper carbonate and water layer. Actually, the last part of experiment, I really faced the difficulty because I took the procedure from Neil Reid YouTube channel, and he used vacuum filter to separate precipitate and water. However, I don't have vacuum filter, So I tried to separate them by filter paper and evaporation.
Actually, I waited around 1 week.
2,000 years later.
Finally, I get copper carbonate salt. Maybe I can use copper carbonate for another experiment. If you like my experiment, please subscribe my channel so I can make more experiments.